Hello everybody, Silentwisher here with a quick Steam related video, specifically an Arma Steam related video. If you've ever wondered to know how to check to see what mods have updated for Arma, because you'll notice in downloading here, Arma 3 Workshop content. Well, most people don't realize if you click this View News button, it will tell you your most recently updated mods. So in this case, on the 21st, Eden Enhance updated, as well as the Hornet beta for the F-18. So let's check out this Eden Enhance. I'm going to skip the F-18, but let's see. Do we have change logs here? Yep, we do. We got some translations and some bug fixes. So that's wonderful. So that's how you check to see what kind of mods have updated if the game supports it. Obviously, things like Grand Theft Auto don't. They have their own patch note system and all that, but that's how you check what is updated. Hello everybody, Silentwisher here with another quick Arma 3 video for you. Specifically, this is a Arma 3 troubleshooting video. So we're going to talk about how to troubleshoot if you're having issues connecting to our server, the Rough Riders server, any sort of server, or just having troubles with your game as a whole. So first and foremost, the basic is restart the game completely, like completely close it out, as well as completely close out Steam. And if you want to go the extra mile, restart your PC. Then what you would want to do is relaunch Arma after all of that and disable all of your mods, relaunch, and see if your issue persists. Now obviously if you're having an error relating to mods, this one won't necessarily help you. But the next is if it's not your mods, or if it is a mod, you're gonna have to single it out one by one. And if you're unlucky and you have a large mod pack such as this one, it's going to take you a while to single it out, especially if it's not giving you any sort of errors. So you will have to do trial and error with that. Another thing is to come to Steam, and you want to verify. You can't have the game running when you do this. You would come to the game in your library, right-click on it, go to Properties, Local Files, and then verify the game cache. I'm going to just do it for the sake of the video here, but it's going to scan and make sure you're not missing anything, including mods. So it's going to verify all your games and verify all your game files and then download everything that you may be missing or is corrupt or something like that. The next thing would be to turn off any sort of custom options you have in the launcher, which I will show you here in just a moment when this is complete. Okay, once your validation is complete, you should see validating Steam files at 100, and then it'll tell you if you're missing anything. You can always check here to see if it's downloading something. But now we're going to talk about the launcher and disabling any sort of custom launcher options that you may have. So once the launcher opens here, what I'm talking about is under the parameters section. If you're having problems, just make sure everything here is set to defaults by hitting to the restore defaults button. And that is another way you can troubleshoot some of your issues. Now, let's say none of that works. Okay, you're still having FPS problems or something like that. Well, if you're using a NVIDIA GPU slash you have access to the GeForce Experience, launch it and go to Arma. Click on Details, and then use the Optimize feature or the Customs Settings button, and then apply a customly optimized profile, graphics profile. NVIDIA does a pretty good job at making sure you have a decent gaming experience. I mean, they're getting this information from lots of different computers, so they kind of know what they're doing. And then, of course, make sure you have your latest driver, which in my case, I do not. So having your latest driver is good, and unless, of course, you know the latest driver has some sort of bug, wait a couple weeks, then install it. But last but certainly not least, and it's unfortunately the nuclear option in this case, if you're still having issues with your Arma, you might need to completely reinstall it. But before you do, if you'd like to reach out to me or my team on my Discord server, you can go into it via the link in the description below. And ask in our tech help section, and we will do our best to help you. No guarantees, of course, but that is all of the ways you can troubleshoot Arma 3. Hopefully this video was helpful to you in some way and maybe fixed some of your issues, and I will see you guys in the next video.
Hello there. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Also, drop a like and a comment, and turn on notifications with that little bell. If you'd like to join my Discord server, you can do so by visiting the link in the description.